Big Boys Neighborhood. It's always good, man, to be joined by your Woo. DJ producer peers, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey.
For those out there, I gave up the turntables at Turn Labels years ago, thinking that there was absolutely no future in it. As of yet, I've been proved extremely wrong, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Best believe that. Diplo is in the neighborhood. Skrillex in the neighborhood, man. Jack, you hey. In the neighborhood. First off, man, got to say welcome to the neighborhood. Pleasure
welcome.
To see you fellas, man.
Thanks, man. We live right by here.
Yeah, we actually, it took us like...
It took us 3 minutes to get here.
It's
kind of our neighborhood, too.
Hey, man, so next time we just come by y'all compound.
We have a little... We have some mics. Plus, I can teach you some more DJ tricks. We can still... I told you it's never too late.
Yeah, that's what I was telling. Diplo, I thought about it, man. And you know, I always say, like, E-Man put me back into the game, so on and so forth, but it's just hard now.
We can take it to night school.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Now, let me ask you this, though, Diplo. Now, the DJ business, like, there's a lot of people that's kind of... And Skrillex, there's a lot of people that's kind of jumping in now. Is there a difference, like, a category? Like, when you see, like, a Paris Hilton that could knock down clubs now. You know what I'm saying? Like, do I want to dance to the Paris Hilton club to her mix?
Do you want to go to the club and hang out with her, though?
Not at all.
Well, then that's kind of the main thing.
There it is. You know what I'm saying? Best believe that. And Diplo, man, don't hold your tongue or your fingers with us this morning. Yeah, best believe that. Now, Skrillex, as far as DJing, bro, Crystal has been a stalker of yours for a while.
Watch out.
Not a stalker.
Yeah, well, what would
a
you
fan.
Call it?
A fan. I was a fan. He was in a band before he was DJing, and I was a fan of From First to Last.
Did you
and
ever
he
see
was
the
lead
band?
Singer. Yeah, I saw you guys in high school. Like a few times.
Open your legs up, Sean. Does this look familiar?
It's getting crazy, man.
Open your, show me your crotch. Does that look familiar?
You don't remember this?
Yeah. Hello. So, and then you were saying, like, man, Sonny's a DJ now?
Right. And then, then it turned into Skrillex, and I'm like, oh, cool. He's a DJ now. And then I'm still a fan of your DJ work.
Man. And now, with the world knowing what's going down with you, Skrillex, from just being DJ, producer, like, where's the end game? Is there an end game to it?
I think there really is an end game. I mean, everything's always evolving, and music's changing, and I don't know. I think, like, I mean, I feel like you feel the same way. Like, we like to keep pushing it that way and continue to do what we do, which is...
Yeah, we're just going to keep making music and keep changing the way we do things. And
now, what exactly is Jack U? I know what it meant to me years ago. You know what I'm saying? Best believe that. But what put the fellas together, especially, man, when you think about certain things, like, okay, you got your shine, you got what you do, and sometimes it's like, okay, this is my territory, this is what I do, you know, and I hold on to my audience. What made you guys get together, Diplo?
I think the two of us both are really, we see each other a lot, we're working together a lot, we're producing a lot of records, like you're playing some of the stuff we do in the hip-hop world, like he did some A$AP Rocky records, I did something with like Ty Dolla $ign recently, Chris Brown, we're always producing, but we come from this other world where we're playing festivals and making electronic music, so we wanted to just combine and do something progressive around hip-hop, dance, everything, kind of come together and make something that's really a new sound. And together, I think we're both each other's, you know, we're biggest fans. So it's cool that we can work together and have that quality control and put our resources together.
And I think on that, too, is like a lot of people in EDM, like a lot of it's really safe when it comes to like the main stage stuff. And we're like, I feel like some of the only two producers and DJs who come up on main stages and play stuff like, you know, new hip hop or like really, I guess, progressive, like forward thinking EDM music and stuff that. You know, when you hear the word EDM, a certain sound can come in your head, but I feel like we come from a different angle, and we want to, like, continue to push that on, like, a, you know, on a, the big platform we have.
Skrillex, what's the largest crowd you performed or DJed in front
of? Damn. I think the biggest one, I headlined this festival in Quebec. You were there too.
I was there. I opened for it.
Yeah, and
I know. I'm still sad about it.
It was tight.
honestly, we never. I didn't expect it. We were on a tour together on a train tour like 3 years ago, and he was like, "Oh, we open up for this place in Quebec City." Was that show right?
Yeah, it was over 100,000.
No, it was like
people.
It was like 150,000.
Yeah,
maybe.
It was crazy.
Lord.
Jeez.
Yeah, but we do that all the time. Like in Europe, we both played Rockines, and we played for like 100,000 people. In the summertime, like regularly.
So you guys do that, but recently you guys did a house party too, like random house party.
Yeah,
we don't have a filter between like a house party and a festival. No way.
It's just as important to play stuff. I think even more important.
We DJed at Soul Cycle last night.
Yeah,
that in Santa Monica.
Yeah, we don't care. We don't care. We'll come to your house and play.
We'll come to your Chinese food restaurant.
If we're drunk enough, we'll go anywhere.
I heard that.
Not even drunk.
I'm gonna get some ripping some drinks. New Year's Eve, Madison Square Garden.
That's right.
Wow.
Man. How large is that? Yeah, that's ridiculous, man.
That's like 1 billion people or something.
Yeah.
That's big.
Yeah, man.
So we're trying to fill it up for New Year's Eve and let people like party with us.
But now you guys are in a position, man, where I'm pretty sure every promoter, somebody want to get at you guys for New Year's Eve.
Right.
What make you guys say, no, we're not going to a festival or 100,000 people? What makes Skrillex say, I'm going to, no, let's do Madison Square Gardens?
I think we've both done New Year's Eve the last couple of 10 years. We've all done big parties, Vegas festivals. I think it's really like Madison Square Garden is something once in a lifetime opportunity for a performance. And then for us and our fans too, we have some special stuff lined up. I mean, we're going all out for that. We want to make it real special. And
the lineup is great too. We have ASAP Ferg's going to be there, Rudimental,
nice.
Yellow Claw.
Yeah, some other special guests. We got some live performances coming through with a secret we can't talk about.
Uh-oh. Now, is this like your night as opposed to other nights when it's like, okay, we're live at such and such for New Year's Eve? This is like you guys'
it's
night.
It's our thing, 100%.
Yeah, we curated the whole thing. And
producing. It's crazy because when we do other festivals, we're just, you know, working with the production. We're like in a lineup of a bunch of DJs. This is our night. And we just think we have a lot of exciting music to give people, so we want to like launch our project kind of like at MSG. You can't get any bigger than that and any crazier than that.
Skrillex, you ever played Madison Square before?
No, this is a first for both of us. So.
Do you get a little, not nervous, but like, man, like, what is the sellout? What does it feel like? What's the capacity?
Yeah. That's a pretty big room. Yeah. I mean, I just went and saw Usher at Staples Center the other day. That was a crazy show.
That's
I don't ever get to go to concerts because I'm always working or busy, but to see him play and I was just like blown away by the stage show, and just that's the size of what we're gonna do for New Year's Eve. So.
And you've been doing the Mad Decent block parties, and you put those together yourself.
Yeah, it's like 7 years we've been doing that, and they grow every year. We only had the first year was Philly, it's like 2,000 kids, and every year we grow. We've done 24 this year. New York was like 17,000 people. LA was downtown 10,000 people. The boat was like 3,000 kids in the Bahamas. It just gets every year. We just the kids are growing, the fans are growing for what we're doing. It's really cool. It started as a grassroots project.
Now, what's going down tomorrow? What's the release that's happening tomorrow?
Well, we have the first single, Take You There, we did. And tomorrow, the video debuts. So we're excited to get people that. So tomorrow, you can check out the video. We're going to put it out.
Nice.
Now, how did you release that? Do you just tell people that follow you, like, this is where it's at?
I guess we put it on YouTube or something. I don't know.
Yeah, but you know what I'm saying?
I don't know. That's a great question.
Yeah. Like, yeah, we released it. Hold on.
I don't know.
Get my people on the phone.
How
I
got to
call them right
now.
How are we doing this?
And also, you guys are very active on your social media.
Yeah, you got to be.
Right. And you're a Snapchat god right now.
Oh, yeah. We just really rocking the Snapchat the last week. We just got our Snapchat
got
popping.
Really, though?
No. It's Skrillo.
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 Someone took Skrillex, so I got Skrillo.
Somebody squatting on Skrillex?
Yeah, he's squatting on it. Holding it down.
Yeah.
Damn. That person's like, hey,
if we find out where you live, we're going to take the Uber there in a minute.
Squat on you. Right.
Yeah, squat on you.
And talking about the Uber, big, I was telling you.
So you did the Uber driving last week?
I tried it out, you know, just in case the DJ, we don't sell out Madison Square Garden, I might go Uber in.
If this doesn't work for you.
Yeah.
Right. So you were driving, picking people up?
I picked a few people up out in Beverly Hills.
That's dope. Did they know it was you?
They knew me because you can see my face and you can order me on the thing, on the app.
Did they give you 5 stars?
They
he
better
was,
have.
He was threatening people on Twitter, like, you better give me 5 stars.
Uber made me delete that,
because
I was like, I'll come to your house. Uber was like, yo, we're drivers.
That's
too
are.
Scary.
I'll turn back and bust your windows
but
out.
One group, I made them go to Chick-fil-A, so I don't think they only gave me 3 stars, because I didn't even take them home.
Oh. All righty, man. Y'all going to jump back on the turntable. Yes,
I want to,
We're going to get them back in the mix, man. Jack, you in the neighborhood. Skrillex, Diplo, Big Boys
Big
Neighborhood,
boy.
Power 106.
Special thanks to Robert Wayne Footwear and Doc Martens.